there are three things I want to talk about today. First, obviously everyone knows, Georgia Governor Kemp has pushed us back to Jim Crow, at least his state. Now the rest of the states will probably follow suit because their point of the matter is, this bill that they were working on for all this time, ever since they lost, the Republicans lost the Senate and the House, and especially the presidency. Governor Kemp has put us on the step towards Jim Crow. Now that's angering me enough, but what really angered me was this.
The governor is signing a bill that affects all Georgians. Why is he doing it in private, and why is he trying to keep elected officials who are representing us out of the process?
Exactly. Are you serious?
No, you are not representing.
She's not under arrest.
What is for what? Under arrest for what? For trying to see something that our governor is doing? Our governor is signing a bill that affects all Georgians, and you're going to arrest an elected representative. Why are you arresting her? Tell us now. Why are you arresting her? Cited. Give me a reason why you are arresting her. Give me a reason why you are arresting her. Representative, you are choosing to arrest an elected official.
You arrested someone who tried to open the door on a secret pact for you to try to steal our rights, steal American rights from American citizens of color. You made it a felony for people for me to even give a bottle of water down there to someone who would be standing in line for hours on end. You cut down early voting time, not to mention absentee voting for people who may have to make the choice between going to work or going to vote. That is the very definition of voter suppression, and it will not be tolerated. And what I saw in that video, and what you saw in that video, was nothing short of what African Americans went through during and even after the Civil Rights Movement, after the Voting Rights Movement was actually made into law. So I want three things. Firstly, I want Governor Kemp's head, but since I can't have that, I want his resignation. For violating civil rights and for a conspiracy to steal the 2020 election and perhaps the 2024 election. Because we all know where this is coming from. We all know where this is going. They're doing this because they think their chances of getting back the White House, of Donald Trump getting back the White House, will increase if they stop up the black people from voting. That's all that this has all been about. And maybe also the Republicans are doing this to save their own asses. Maybe that's what it is. If that's the case, it's pretty fucking pathetic. Because if you can't honestly win back your Senate seats, win back your congressional seats by just campaigning, doing the right thing, making the promises, keeping the promises, then you have no business being in those seats. The second thing I want is for Governor Kemp and the police officers that arrested that Georgia representative you saw in that video, I want them all to apologize publicly. I want CNN there. I want ESPN. Maybe not ESPN. I want ABC, CBS, NBC, MSNBC. Hell, I want Fox News there. But I'm going to get to them in a second. But you're going to grovel and beg for that woman's forgiveness. Because what the country, what the planet just saw, was our country going back to the old ways, back to Jim Crow. I'm damn surprised they didn't beat this woman. I'm surprised they didn't beat her up right in there in the state house, in the Georgia state house. Because that's what we're heading towards. And right now we have the encouragement, these people have the encouragement of racists that are still clinging to this lie that Donald Trump was, that the election was stolen from Donald Trump. More on that later. The third thing I want, and I need you all to listen to me very carefully about this. Vote. Vote in 2022. Vote in 2024. I keep telling people, especially African Americans on my Facebook page, or when I see them in church, or when I see them in public, a lot of them tell me, it doesn't matter if I vote, what's the point? Here's the point. If your rights to vote weren't so important, why are people like Governor Kemp, Senator Rubio, Senator Cruz, Senator Holloway, Congresswoman Green, Congresswoman Bobbitt, Donald Trump himself, why are they breaking their asses to take that right away from you? Why are they breaking their backs trying to steal that right from you? Vote. Because let me tell you something. The most powerful people, the most powerful thing in this country isn't the gun. Although a lot of Second Amendment assholes out there say this. It's our rights. And the number one right that all Americans have, all races, all genders, all religions, all creeds, all colors, is our right to vote. They're trying to steal it from you. And we all know why. The second thing I want to talk to you all about is the fact that Fox News is getting sued again. This time by Dominion Voting, to the tune of $1.6 billion. Obviously, we already know why they're getting sued, for their continuation and their pushing of the big lie. The big lie that the election of 2020 was rigged and stolen from Donald Trump. The lie that has actually put their employees in danger. 1.6 million, that won't destroy Fox News. We know this. Their credibility is destroyed, and they don't give a shit. Sean Hannity doesn't. Tucker Carlson doesn't, because they know their viewers are going to keep watching it because they love what they hear. It fits into their conspiracy-driven brains of theirs. And more to the point, it fits into the mindset of the Donald Trump supporter. Jeanine Pirro, Kathy McGlinery, in fact, all of Lou Dobbs, although Lou Dobbs is gone, but he's been named in the suit. My advice to Fox News, get your checkbooks out. Pay them the money. Because if you don't, you take this to trial, it will only destroy Fox News. Fox News is already destroyed as it is. Don't make the pain even worse. The last thing I want to talk about, again, Fox News, Donald Trump decided to talk his mouth off on Fox News about January 6th. The one subject that Donald Trump should not mention for the rest of his life. Now, Donald Trump still has lawsuits hanging over his head, especially from the NAACP on what happened on January 6th. And several others, and he still could be facing criminal charges. But the one thing that I don't think this asshole actually understands is he doesn't have the protection of the presidency any longer. So whatever he says is going to be used against him. Anyway, in the Fox News interview last night, he says this.
Right from the start, I knew it was zero threat. Look, they went in. They shouldn't have done it. Some of them went in and they were hugging and kissing the police and the guards, you know. They had great relationships. A lot of the people went in, and they walked in, and they walked out.
Revisionist history. He's trying to change. He's trying to reinvent history to saying January 6th didn't matter. Nothing bad happened. Yes, it did, Trump. Over 100 police officers were injured. One officer died on the scene. Two others committed suicide not too long after. So, yeah. There are a lot of things did happen on January 6th, and you continually opening your mouth is going to make the situation worse. I want you to keep talking. Because every time you open your big fat mouth, it's going to be used against you. Maybe you're not as smart as you think you are. Maybe you don't understand that you're not protected by the power of the presidency anymore. Or maybe you think that just because I'm Donald Trump, I slept with 50 women. I'm a billionaire. I can do whatever I want. And none of it will come back to you. Well, this is going to come back to you, Trump. This is going to come back to you. 2024, that's a long way away. But you're not going to be president ever again. The last name Trump gets back in the White House is if your idiotic daughter-in-law or your doofus sons, Beavis and Butthead, become president. And that might not even happen either, considering the fact that they were complicit in the attack. An attack that you're trying to minimize and actually bold-faced lie about. Yeah, some of the protesters were peaceful, but not all of them. It's sure as hell not the ones who got into the Senate chamber and read off names, read off documents, saying that they were trying to look for people who are loyal to Trump. Especially that QAnon shaman who is trying to bray like a goat. Oh, oh, really? And you're trying to tell me that they're peaceful? They were kissing and hugging the police and guards, you know? Really, Trump? Keep talking. Because this is going to get your... Oh, by the way, that I want you to keep talking, because that burning sensation around your neck area here, that's a noose, Trump. And every time you open your mouth, it's going to get tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter. Now, I don't wish death on you, but you got only two choices at this point. Run, you can cut and run, or you can stay here trying to think you're God's gift to the world, and you can try to run. And I don't mean run for office, I mean run. God, there are so many times I wish I was an actor. Someone like Joe Morton on Scandal. Because there's this line from his character on Scandal. He keeps saying, run, Trump. Run, because quite frankly, you may not even live to be into 2024. You may not be free. You may be sitting in a jail cell, if not the old age home. Start hemming your garments now. Start grieving. Curse the heavens, and Trump, it'll save you time down the road. But first, Trump, run. This is CT. You know what? There is one more thing I need you all to listen to. What I'm about to read is a statement from the current president of the United States, Joe Biden, and his reactions to this revamped idea of Jim Crow, of rights, of voters' rights being stolen by the Republican Party. Take a listen to this. More Americans voted in the 2020 election than any election in our nation's history. In Georgia, we saw this most historical demonstration of the power of the vote twice, in November and again in the runoff election for the U.S. Senate seats in January. Recount after recount and court case after court case upheld the integrity and the outcome of clean, free, fair, and secure democratic process. Yet, instead of celebrating the rights of all Georgians to vote or winning campaigns on the merits of their ideas, Republicans in the state instead rushed through an un-American law to deny people the right to vote. This law, like so many others being pushed by Republicans in state houses across the country, is a blatant attack on our Constitution and good conscience. Among the outrageous parts of this new state law, it would end voting hours early, so working people cannot cast their vote after their shift is over. It adds rigged restrictions on casting absentee ballots that will effectively deny the right to vote to countless voters, and make it a crime to provide water to voters while they wait in line. Lines Republican officials themselves have created by reducing the number of polling sites across the state, disproportionately in black neighborhoods. This is the Jim Crow of the 21st century. It must end. We have a moral and constitutional obligation to act. I once again urge Congress to pass the For the People Act and the John Lewis Voting Rights Advancement Act to make it easier for eligible Americans to access the ballot box and prevent attacks on our sacred vote rights to vote. And I will take my case to the American people, including the Republicans, who have joined the broadest coalition of voters ever in the past election to put country before party. If you have the best ideas, you have nothing to hide. Let the people vote.